else speak in here. Kim, you look fabulous today. I'm talking stunning, beautiful, wow. Hurry it up, come on. By the way, thank you for agreeing to marry our little brother, despite his lack of an Ivy League education. I guess the fact that you have two makes up for it. But it's not like she tries to hide it. Have you guys seen her email signature? She name drops Penn and Columbia. Kim, what are you gonna do next? Change your email address to kim@ivyleagueeducationandyou.com?
Now to Robbie, our little brother. Last but not least of three little boys. I'm sure you've all heard the stereotype about the youngest child in a family. Well, that stereotype was founded upon the behavior of one individual who happens to be seen here in the room with us. Robbie is the prototypical youngest child. He gets away with everything. When my parents caught me with beer in high school, I was lectured, sanctioned with driving limitations, and grounded. When our mom found Scott's beer stash in her compost bin, he was placed under house arrest. When Robbie left the beer in the fridge, not even trying to hide it, nothing. They didn't even confiscate it. The kid did whatever he wanted. He creates his own rules to play by.
Rules that always seem to benefit him. For instance, you know how most kids have a birthday party and invite all their friends so they can have cake and hang out? Well, Robbie had different motives. He saw every invitation going out as a present coming in. The more, the better. But don't worry, everybody. I'm sure for his wedding, he only invited the people he loved the most. And a few of you guys who give really nice gifts. Now, stubbornness is another one of Robbie's traits that he shares with the stereotype. The year was 1996, and our dad took Robbie and I to Key West on vacation. We stopped for dinner, and Robbie ordered a chicken rice dish. The waiter warned him that it was spicy and asked him if he still wanted it. Undeterred, Robbie responded with the now timeless phrase, "I will survive." However, survive he did not. After just one, maybe two bites, his mouth was on fire. There wasn't enough Diet Coke in all of Florida to get him through that meal. But he was too proud to admit he made a mistake and wouldn't order anything else. Robbie never admits when he's wrong. Good luck, Kim.
Talking about responsibility, how about borrowing a family heirloom beach chair and losing it? No big deal. How about never cleaning up your own messes? Whatever, someone else will do it. He might be responsible in most respects, but when it comes to money, he means business. I don't know how else to say it. Robbie has an obsession with money. I mean, Kim, don't take this the wrong way. He loves you too. But he was in a serious relationship with the greenback decades before he ever mentioned it. And I hate to break it to you right here on your wedding day, they never really broke up. Their love affair started when he was about 7 years old. My dad used to pay us to shred files from his office. I think the arrangement was one penny for every file we shredded. Well, Robbie, the shrewd businessman that he was, felt that we were being underpaid. So we took up the cause of the working man himself and fought to get us better wages.
He actually renegotiated.